Hey everyone, it's Nicole Spohr for Spellbinders. Today I am sharing a set of four silhouetted Christmas cards with inked and stenciled backgrounds that really show off these beautiful A Sweet Christmas silhouette dies. This is a really fun and easy technique, and it shows off these beautiful, intricate Christmas dies perfectly. I'm using the following dies to create my cards today. The Lighting the Way Etched Dies, A Sweet Christmas, the Hanging Stockings, and From Our Home to Yours, as well as the really cute Santa Parade. You can see that these are very detailed and just really beautiful dies. I couldn't pick just one, so I decided to do a whole set of four cards. Now, each background was created pretty much the same with a few minor differences. For my first two cards, I did an inked background, and then I'm going to stencil some falling snow before adding my dies. This background was created with Lucky Clover Distress Oxide ink in kind of an ombre pattern, lighter at the top, darker down near the bottom. The dies are going to be stacked and adhered down near the bottom edge, so that I want that color kind of concentrated there so they really pop off of this beautiful background. I'm going to take a white pigment ink then with the falling snow stencil and stencil my snow right over this inked background. You could also maybe spritz this with water from a distress sprayer or a mister or something, a mini mister or something like that, if you want to skip this step and get a similar look. You could also stamp snowflakes in the background. That would be really pretty too, and maybe emboss with white embossing powder. I'm being pretty generous with this white pigment ink. And then I let my backgrounds completely air dry. Because I'm using inks that have either pigment inks or they have pigment ink in them, the Distress Oxide inks, the ink is going to stay wet for a little bit longer. And because of that, it's going to be awfully hard to stamp and emboss the phrase that I'm going to be adding to these cards without that embossing powder sticking to any of the other ink. You can speed this up with a heat tool if you want to, or you can do like I did. I kind of did all of this one day. I let them sit probably overnight and came back and did the rest of it the next day or later in the day. I can't remember exactly, but just give them enough time to air dry if you're not going to speed that up with a heat tool. The other background that is very similar, it's just going to be a landscape design instead of the more portrait look, is going to be inked with Blueprint Sketch Distress Oxide ink. I love the Blueprint Sketch. Again, concentrating the ink down near the bottom edge, lightening it as we get to the top, and then we're going to stencil over that falling snow again. I try to do any of the backgrounds that were going to be the same at the same time so that I only had to clean my stencils once, unless I was switching colors, which you will see when I do the brick backgrounds here in a little bit. And there are lots and lots of options out there for how you might want to ink or stencil your background. I went for Christmas theme, obviously, and I also let the dies I'm using dictate kind of the design I wanted for the background. And that just means that for two of the backgrounds, they looked kind of outdoorsy. The Santa Parade especially, and they look like they're out, you know, grabbing their Christmas tree, they're on a sled. And then also the Santa with the reindeer and the little boy, that also looked outdoorsy. For my other, that's called Lighting the Way, by the way. The other two, the Hanging the Stockings, to me, that looked more like indoors, so I'm using a Tim Holtz bricked stencil with Fired Brick Distress Oxide ink, and then the From Our Home to Yours, which is the Santa in the bag silhouettes. I felt like those looked more like indoor type of scenes, so I picked stencils and backgrounds that worked better with that. Because this brick stencil does not fit all the way across my card, you'll have to be a little bit creative. I did not mind an overlap. I tried to line it up as close as possible, but really, once you get your dies over there, your greetings in place, both the die cut greetings and the stamped greetings, you're not going to notice some of those little imperfections. In fact, I kind of like the imperfections. And then the last background was created with Hickory Smoke Distress Ink, and I just left that off. Again, we're going to have a portrait and a landscape style. Now, what I loved for this project was I wanted my sentiment to be really bold and glittery. I feel like that gives a great Christmas feel to these cards. So I adhered little pieces of glitter cardstock scraps to Fun Foam, adhered those with Stick-It adhesive, and then I am using the Merry Christmas from either Santa Parade or From Our Home to Yours, there's a Merry Christmas in either one of those, to die cut that sentiment. One of my cards is going to have a little bit different sentiment, and that did not work as well because it's so tiny. So I will kind of talk to you about how I did that in a little bit. My backgrounds are completely dry. I have die cut my images. We are going to start with this awesome Lighting the Way, a Sweet Christmas die. I've die cut it 3 times. I want that to be really bold. You could just do it 1 time, but I want it to pop off the background without having to die cut it from foam. And for me, the easiest way to do that is to just go ahead and die cut it 3 times and glue them one on top of another. Before I glue anything in place, if there's any embossing I'm going to do on the background, I like to get that done. I decided a little stamped phrase would coordinate with the die cut greeting perfectly. I'm going to stamp this sentiment, go ahead, sprinkle on my embossing powder, tap that off, and heat set that. I love how the white embossing looks against these falling snow backgrounds. The other two cards with the bricked backgrounds, because there's some white space, I don't think the white embossing will work as well. We'll stamp those sentiments with a black ink so that they really show up nicely against the bricked backgrounds. Let's take our dies now, the Lighting the Way, and this fits perfectly across the bottom of an A2 sized card, meaning it is 4¼ inches wide. I used a little liquid adhesive on the back of these, and I'm going to stack them one on top of another. You could stack them before you take them to your project. I went ahead and just lined it up with the bottom of my background, and then I'm going to glue them in place. I put acrylic blocks on top to hold them flat while that liquid glue dries. And I'm going to continue to do this for all 3 layers. I think the stacking makes a really big difference, and it's a very simple and easy way to really draw your attention to these beautiful silhouetted images. Everything else we're doing for this card is to make this image really pop. This gives a really classic, elegant feel to these cards. And again, just keep putting my acrylic blocks on top, letting that dry. Now you want to carefully peel your die cut greetings out from the glitter cardstock. The fantastic thing is these dies will die cut all the way through. The Spellbinders Platinum die cutting machine, I ran them through 1 time, only once, and it cut through the glitter cardstock, Stick-It adhesive, 2 layers of that, and Fun Foam, and it cut them beautifully. I'm using the tool-in-one to pop out any of those little sections from inside my letters. And then I want to center the word Christmas and pop that right above my stamped greeting. And I just kind of want to work nice and slow to get that as straight as possible. I love the tone on tone, but I love that touch of glitter. I'm a huge fan of combining a die cut, scripty, dimensional greeting with a stamped phrase, and then of course the beautiful silhouetted die cut there creates a very classic, beautiful design. So we're going to take the word Merry now, do the same thing. We're just going to pop out the little center of the E and the Y, and then find the best arrangement for this, I think it looks a little bit better offset kind of over towards the right. Again, get that as straight as possible. And that looks so pretty. Now, don't forget the little dot for the eye. I'm going to use my tool in one to grab that. And then even though there's some stick-it adhesive, it's not going to be very sticky for such a small little die cut piece. I generally like to take a little dab of liquid adhesive, in this case, Ranger Multi Matte Medium, put a little dab of that there, and then pop the dot for the eye down in place. And it was giving me a little bit of trouble. I was trying to use tweezers and the tool in one to keep my fingers out of it, and that worked great. And now I don't have to worry about that disappearing or falling off. Now the final thing we're gonna do, and this is what I did for all four cards, is finish with some Nuvo crystal drops and a scattering of some little mini silver star confetti. I think that adds a festive feel to the background, dresses it up a little bit, gives it some beautiful embellishment without overpowering the die cuts. We want that beautiful silhouetted die cut to be the star of the show. Everything else is just drawing your attention. So the Simply White Nuvo Crystal Drops reinforce the falling snow feel, kind of gives it that illusion that they're walking through the snow. So the ones we stenciled are off in the background. The Nuvo Crystal Drops are a little bit more in the foreground. That was my feel, or what I was thinking as I designed this. And then the stars just add to the festive feeling of the design. They're small, they're sparkly. I'm using a jewel picker to kind of pick these up, pop them in place throughout my background. You can maybe use gold if you prefer gold, or use some other kind of sequin if you want to. I think the key here is to find things that reinforce the scene or the card design that you're creating without overpowering the focal point, which is Merry Christmas and the silhouetted image. I'm going to add a few here and there. I like the Ranger Multi-Matte Medium for this. Glossy Accents would work. Other kinds of liquid adhesive. Just something nice and strong so you don't have to worry about anything falling off. Then we'll pop this onto a white top fold card base, and that will finish off the design. Let's move on to the other background that we created, very similar to the first card, and this was with the Blueprint Sketch Distress Oxide ink. Again, I have stamped and embossed a sentiment here. We'll pop a Merry Christmas above this, but this time we're using the Santa Parade die. And this die is nice and long. So maybe if you were creating a larger card, this would go across the whole thing. But I'm creating a set of A2 sized cards. So I kind of had to be very conscious of how I adhered this to my card base. So I looked at the border and I decided I could eliminate the little kid at the back of the parade line holding the present without really losing any of the rest of the design. And I'm going to stack these one on top of another. You could trim them off one at a time. It might be a little bit easier, so you don't have to go through so many layers of cardstock. This is heavyweight white cardstock, so you get three layers of this together. It can be kind of thick. Depending on what kind of scissors you have, I might want to say you might want to cut them one at a time. I have some Tim Holtz scissors here from Tonic Studios. They worked really well to die cut, or pardon me, not die cut, trim the rest of that. It just kind of depends on what you have. But you can see now the border, it's not really missing all that much by trimming that off. So just be really aware when you are trimming down something like this, kind of the placement of all of the elements, so that you're not maybe cutting right through Santa. Or the little boy, I think it would have looked a little bit funny to not have the little boy pulling the sled and just have that sled right there. So I was really careful when determining where I wanted to trim that down. Again, this background is going to have some Nuvo Crystal Drops in Simply White, which is that beautiful opaque white to reinforce the falling snow feel. And then I'm going to have some mini silver star confetti scattered throughout. This time the Merry Christmas was die cut from Fun Foam attached to, or silver glitter cardstock attached to the Fun Foam. Let's move on to our bricked backgrounds. For the first one here, I did do a different sentiment. And like I mentioned a little bit earlier, it did not die cut well from the Fun Foam. It was really tricky, but I still wanted it to be a little bit dimensional. So in order to do this, I am going to die cut my greetings from a few layers, or two layers, pardon me, of just regular smooth white cardstock, stack those one on top of another, and finish with a glitter cardstock layer. Just plain glitter cardstock, not on Fun Foam or anything like that. And then for the last card, again, we have a brick background, but we're going to go back to the first design with the large Merry Christmas. It just fit the space better. Mostly how I chose what I was using was what fit the space and what worked with the stamped sentiment below. And of course, Merry Christmas is going to work beautifully for both. And then a scattering of Nouveau crystal drops. I used a little autumn red here, Simply White, added some silver star confetti. You could do whatever you want. I die cut glitter cardstock for the little holly berries, red glitter, crimson, I guess, and emerald to dress up the Santa sack there. Really, really fun. So here is a look at all four finished cards with those beautiful silhouetted backgrounds, some dimensional die cut glittery greetings, and of course, some embellishments that help reinforce the Christmas theme and feel. If you have any questions about these cards, please leave them in the comments below and be sure to subscribe to the Spellbinders YouTube channel for more instructional videos. Thank you guys so much for joining me for these Christmas cards today, and we'll see you next time.